Hey everyone, we are really excited to have just released a major update for September 2024. I wanted to quickly cover everything that's new because it's a pretty dense one. So I'm going to be covering encrypted assets and images, offline images, deep links, which a lot of people have been asking for, new lock screen activity for audio notes and voice transcriptions, and the ability to now zoom into images on iOS. And I'll also show you some text selection there. And for these first few, I'm just going to kind of first two, I'll just describe because there's not much to show. Then I'll cover deep links on this desktop here. And then I'm going to move over to my iPhone to show you those iOS specific things. So let's get started quickly with encrypted assets. That's just what it sounds like. Any file or image or anything you add into Reflect is now end-to-end encrypted. Previously, these were stored under a secure link. So this is just an additional layer of security. And if you're someone that likes to save images to your notes, you can now be confident in saving more sensitive things like, you know, medical reports, screenshots with sensitive text. They are now end-to-end encrypted, just like the rest of your notes. Not much more to go over there, so let me move on to offline images, and this one will be pretty quick too. Just what it sounds like, you can now access images you save to Reflect while offline. And that also counts for saving images as well. So if you save an image to your Reflect notes, then as soon as you go online again, it will just sync like the rest of your notes do. So again, you can both save and view images offline now, which is pretty helpful. Some of you may have noticed before, because of that link storage, when you went offline, the images would no longer show up. So for those offline people, that's a big one. Let me now cover Deeplink. This one is a bit more interesting. So Wojtek put together this nice page on our Reflect Academy, just at reflect.academy/deeplinks. You can also access it in the tab down here. And if you're someone that really wanted deep links, or maybe you're just someone that uses Zapier a lot or our API a lot, this will now let you do a lot more complex workflows and do it with a lot fewer clicks. So this whole document kind of outlines exactly what you can do with these deep links, but it both opens specific things in Reflect and will perform specific actions. So I'll just kind of scroll through this quickly and hopefully do a deeper dive later on. But for example, you can append things to your daily note. You can create tasks, you can create a note, edit notes, and there's a bunch of examples here that you can do based on ID, subject. It all supports Markdown, whatnot. And again, this is really going to be a big feature to people that build a lot of their own workflows, either through the API or through Zapier. So check that out and stay in touch for a more in-depth video. If you're someone new to Deeplinks, it is a little bit more complex, so I'm going to try and collect some favorite workflows that people use them for and cover those in a later video. Okay, so let me now move over to my iOS and or my iPhone to show you these iOS specific things. Okay, so I'm now on my iPhone here, and I'm going to cover the last two here, lock screen activity for audio notes and image zoom on iOS. So let's first do lock screen. So if I start a voice recording here, click the plus button at the bottom right and then the microphone, you'll see that I am now transcribing an audio message. And if I close out my phone and just click on the button to open the lock screen, you now see at the bottom here, among kind of, you know, the regular scrolling apps is the, I don't know what you'd call this. Is this a widget? We'll just call it lock screen activity, but I can close this out. You know, if I'm going for a walk, I can close my phone and put it in my pocket. And then once I'm done, I can just click on the button and stop it right from the home screen. And I don't even have to unlock or open my phone again. And just like normal, it will open up, or sorry, it will transcribe to my daily note. So it otherwise works just like any other audio note. It's just a little lock screen activity for convenience. All right, last one here. So this one's kind of fun. So this is now image zoom on iOS. So let's pretend this is my daily note, and this is actually a real example. So let me go find, I was going to this gym in Austria here, and nothing here is in English. I don't speak German. So I took a photo of the hours here, and in this scenario, it's actually pretty easy to understand what it's saying, but let's kind of, you know, for the sake of argument, say I can't figure out what it says. And for one, if I'm just looking at the hours, I can now zoom in and, yeah, look at any kind of detailed text that I want. If something is smaller, I think this worked particularly well for screenshots if you're taking screenshots of detailed text, but I don't know. There's a bunch of reasons you might want to zoom in on a photo. So that's new, that we just released that. And something that's also kind of fun that, to be honest, I was a little bit hesitant to show because I think we're going to have a lot of improvements on this in an upcoming launch, not to tease it too much, but I want to go ahead and mention this because I do think it's very cool. you can actually select and interact with text on images that you add here. So if I just tap and hold on this word here, it then selects the word. I'm going to drag it to the whole line, and I can then copy, look up. Translate is particularly useful in this scenario. So opening hours for members, probably could have guessed that, but I think that's kind of fun. You could also, you know, share the text, search it on the web, and kind of all the usual actions off of it. So that's pretty cool. If you're someone that saves a lot of screenshots and stuff, I think that is particularly useful. So I will call that good for this video, and go check it out. I hope you enjoy the new features, and particularly if you have Deeplink workflows that you're using, I would love to hear about those so that I can include them in the upcoming video. Thanks, everyone.